Let's begin with the market voice. We've got Shailendra Kumar, Director and CIO of Narnolia Securities, who's joining us on the show this afternoon. Shailendra, good afternoon to you. Let's start off first with what's happened to some of those bigger power names and what happens to the banks now post the Supreme Court ruling out the Feb 12 circular of the RBI.
Yeah. See, the ruling the Supreme Court has given today, marginally it's positive for Indian banks for sure. One thing that has to be watched out, that Supreme Court has given the verdict in context of power companies. Now, maybe this is sector agnostic, maybe other sectors like infra will also be getting benefited. Surely, we are not going, the RBI will not go back to the era of CDR, S4A and SDR. But this realization that every asset will go to NCLT and the IBC process, the realization had been for long in the market. So in a power asset, if you go to the IBC straight away, 80-85% kind of a haircut would be there for regions which were not in the hands of promoter erstwhile. So this ruling, I think, is positive in the context of both banks. Also, RBI will surely come out with some kind of a clarity on what kind of a mechanism will be there from here on, because every sector is a little unique in India. You can't blame promoter straight away for every NPA going on. So it's a positive step. I think some new mechanism will come. Even say, based on 12th of the last RBI circular in the question, say Jet Airways, the resolution which is going on, so 180 days fixed time period, I think that also will be getting some positive boost because of the circular getting quashed by Supreme Court.
Okay. Mr. Narnolia, Mr. Kumar, rather, the other question is, while does this in any way change the trajectory for investing that people would have into banks which have exposures to some of these assets? Because this, we do not know what the final outcome of this ruling will be, but banks which have exposure to some of these assets wherein there was maybe danger of X happening versus Y, would you base your investment decision based on this?
Yeah. See, no, not based upon this for sure. See, these assets which are there in the question, the loan were given between, say, 2011 and 2013, or say 2010 and 2013 primarily. From there on, the advances growth is already happening in other segment of economy. So as a percentage of overall loan book, this stressed pocket continuously reduce every quarter with the other loan growth happening in industrial and retail sectors. This, stressed pocket, I can call it, continuously on a percentage basis reduces. That's one part of it. Secondly, right now, at least you have a clarity on what are the maximum extent of stress possible. Every corporate bank, has now running at a PCR of 75-80%. They were close to 35-40% in 2013-14 when the NPA cycle started. So banks are in a much better position than what they were 3-4 years back in terms of providing a provision for some kind of a surprises in the NPA trajectory. Overall, they are in good shape. NIMR of the banks are improving. So leave aside this pocket, because this is a computable, a known devil right now. And the other pockets of growth has already moved for the banks. So banks remain a positive in spite of this known pocket of NPA existing in the system.
Mr. Kumar, the other pocket in focus is the auto pack. Tata Motors, the last couple of days, has revved up big time. I know the movement got lost amidst that fake news article that was floating around. But the other big piece was the management reiteration about how quarter four will not be as bad, and the worst was seen in quarter three. What's happening in Tata Motors? And a stock which is no longer at 135, 140, but at almost 200. What's the investment case now, if any?
Surely, there are some incremental positive for Tata Motors with the large provisioning in Q3. And also, if you remember some, 10-15 days back, Chinese court gave a ruling that somebody who was selling some kind of a duplicate for Jaguar has been banned in the market. So that's again incrementally positive. Somebody building a very high growth for Tata Motor will not be, getting, realized as such. But incrementally, things are positive. Does that create an investment thesis for Tata Motor? I don't think it, because see, CV market in India also is not showing any larger uptick. And the balance sheet problem which the Tata Motor consolidated has is not going to go in a hurry. It's a big, large number. It's a cyclical bounce, because incrementally, some numbers will be positive coming out from car sales in China. this might last couple of months at the max. Structurally, things has not changed dramatically for Tata Motors to make it an investment case right now.
But just the fact that things is really not picking up much, even from China, and that's going to be a big stress for Jaguar Land Rover. That's going to have a bearing here on the stock price itself, which just off late has started picking up. So, you know, what would you do in light of that?
Can you come again?
I was talking about the sales not picking up even in the Chinese market. That's the biggest market that they have. And we've not seen a pickup in sales for Jaguar Land Rover in the Chinese market. That is definitely going to have a negative bearing on Tata Motors as a whole.
Right. Surely for Tata Motors, the Jaguar particularly, the number either from US or Europe were also very benign for a very long term. The kind of growth people are speaking about, the global situation, doesn't give you any kind of a positive outlook for either the sales coming from US or Europe. China is the only market where last calendar year 2018 or 17, the larger part of growth came for Tata Motors. That market also is not going to grow rapidly from here on. So macro headwind is already against Tata Motors. There were some minor glitches in Tata Motor China particularly initiative, which has got little bit thrashed out, little bit cleaned. So that number will be slightly positive, but you cannot think of some kind of double digit growth happening with Tata Motor in a hurry. So that pocket, this bounce back is justified on account of some lessening of issue in China market. But broadly, to create an investment thesis for me in terms of 3-year outlook, I don't still have the comfort of the numbers.
What about Cyient and the move in today's session? The stock's down 11%. The management talking about a dip in their revenue as well as their EPS guidance that they had put out because of some key orders getting deferred. Does it have a longer term impact on the stock price, or this is just an aberration that we're seeing?
I think you're talking about Cyient, right?
Yeah.
Okay. See, naturally, the kind of a space Cyient handles, the engineering space, and the couple of larger, aircraft manufacturer of the world are client of Cyient. So when the issue with the Boeing and other players started, there's already talk among the analysts that the Cyient will have some kind of a downgrade in sales number for this quarter and maybe a couple of quarter going ahead. So I think this 10% slide which has happened in the price is still, the valuation has not come to a point where all the negative headwinds are taken care of. So I think little more downside room is there for Cyient stock from where the re-rating can start.
Okay. Shailendra, the other set of newsmakers are Airtel and Vodafone. The last couple of days I've seen some, while the stock has come off, heard enough and more smart money get into Vodafone simply because of the numbers or the perceived value at which it is available. Bharti Airtel has been on a bit of a roll the last couple of days, up 5% today, was up in the green yesterday as well. What do you make of this space?
See, the Vodafone Idea, the kind of valuation it has come, surely looked little interesting. But the problem with the whether Bharti or Vodafone is still right now, we do not have a specific clarity on how the ARPU will increase from here on. What kind of a balance it intensity will require once the 5G starts rolling in. So these valuation induced bounce back in these names will not be very sustainable. You require the return ratio improvement, you require a smooth improvement in the EBITDA of these company, which is still not the case. The only thing positive for these names are valuations are not that high that they commanded in the past. So every time somebody with a value orientation will come and buy and lift the price by say 20%, 30%, but those rally again will not be sustainable till the profit loss account of this company. You cannot foresee 3 years of a smooth movement in the EBITDA in terms of say ROCE. Till that time, these rally will be quite lumpy. There will not be smooth run. So still, somebody with a risk-averse attitude, somebody looking for a pure alpha, these stocks still is not attractive. I think this is good as short-term maybe trading idea, I would say, at the best.
What's the idea that Narnolia is pushing right now?
See, surely, look at the market right now, the 9% rally, 10% rally in the Nifty over last 2 months. The bank Nifty is providing a strong leadership. They're up by 16-17%. market per se for 3-4 months of, you know, nice base building between November last year and February this year has started this rally. And inside the rally, if you look at every 3-4 days, some correction going on. So Bank Nifty is not performing for last 2 days now. So there is a smoother correction happening every 3-4 days during this rally. So somebody, you know, so this this requires some short-term investor event to change the attitude from sell on rally to buy on dip kind of a market. Bank for now, I think in another good many months will remain the leader for this market. So every decline is good for buying corporate lenders that we have kept on speaking in the past as well. As we move towards the second half of this calendar year, that I think the trajectory will move to a stocks of cement, some capex company, infrastructure company, defense expenditure driven company. But right now, for near term, a quarter or two, the leadership will remain with the banking stocks.
Okay. Shailendra, we'll leave it at that. Thanks so much for taking the time out and being with us today and giving us your thoughts. Appreciate your time. Well, let's stick to the topic that we started the conversation with Shailendra Kumar with. The Supreme Court has struck down the RBI's February 12th circular. The Apex Court, which has